And now, your First Alert 5 weather.
And welcome back, everyone. Today is Monday, the 13th of December, and seeing double nickels on the map, probably not as nice as double sevens on the 13th, but we will take it considering that's still above average for us for this time of the year, although not as warm as those high 60s we enjoyed yesterday. The downside to yesterday's forecast, of course, those gusty winds. Seeing calmer winds, calmer conditions today in Pueblo. A beautiful shot from our live cam situated at our studios there in the Pueblo area. 55 degrees also the current temperature with humidity at 27%. Things are looking nice out there on Main Street in the Kangen City area. 64 degrees. That's one of the warmer spots locally with a little bit of wind coming out of the west at about 10 to 15 miles per hour. We should be back under weather alert on Tuesday, not because of widespread fire danger, but the eastern and southeastern plains will see another round of red flag warnings. This will go into effect at 10 a.m. and continue until just past sunset at about 6 p.m. Moderate gusts to around 35 miles per hour combined with dry fuels and very low humidity could allow for a rapidly growing wildfire. So you want to avoid any activities that could start a spark out there tomorrow. Same goes for Wednesday, as we're expecting a more widespread issue related to high fire danger. I'll get to that here in just a second. Let's first break down those winds in the Springs. On Tuesday, again, not the strongest gust here, but certainly breezier than what we saw today, with max gust around 20 to maybe 30 miles per hour. And in Pueblo, it looks like afternoon gust here staying in the ballpark of around 10 to 20 miles per hour. Potent storm and atmospheric river event, bringing a lot of very heavy rain to central parts of California tonight, and some very heavy snow to the High Sierra. In fact, they could be measuring snow in excess of 5 to 6 feet by the time Tuesday evening rolls around. And all that energy is making a beeline towards the Centennial State, expecting heavier snows out into the southwestern mountain ranges. Then I think we do get some snow up into the western slope and the central and northern ranges during the day on Tuesday into Wednesday. Cold front is expected to eject east Wednesday morning. Maybe a quick burst of some rain or snow showers along I-25, but really not expecting much accumulation outside of the mountains. Bigger story is going to be the potential for some damaging wind gusts. Take a look at Wednesday morning. Very strong winds coming out of the southwest. Out ahead of the front, we'll stop it again around 9:15. We are just east of the front by that time. Look what happens by 10. Gust around 50 to 70 miles per hour. And I think we see a window of about 4, 5, maybe 6 hours of those strong and damaging wind gusts all the way until about 3 to maybe 5 o'clock. High wind watch is already issued for pretty much the entire eastern half of the state. That's active all day Wednesday, and fire weather watches from Pueblo County down into the southeast plains. Overnight lows tonight with increasing clouds dropping down to the 20s and 30s. Your highs tomorrow with increasing winds, I think, will be a little bit warmer than what we saw this afternoon. By Wednesday, the cold front races through the area. Take a look at the Super 7-day forecast. It comes in during the morning hours. We're talking about wind gusts 50 to 70 miles per hour, strongest between 9 and 3 p.m. and then a quick burst of precip in the morning hours as well. Thursday to Friday, temperatures continue to cool. We'll be dry by next weekend with highs only in the 40s. For Pueblo, up near 70 on Tuesday. Wednesday to Thursday, we're down to the 50s, and we will be weather alert on Wednesday due to those very powerful gusts of wind, the potential for some morning light precipitation. Kangen City, very windy on Wednesday, dry skies through the rest of the 7-day period. And for Woodland Park, maybe a quick burst of snow, could see a half an inch to an inch Wednesday morning. Bigger story though, Allison, gust up over 60 to even 70 miles an hour.